The Sopranos, they're going to be coming back. How are they coming back? You got to find out. That's what this news video is about.
Forget about it.
I got to tell you, Tom, it's a good thing. Not great. It's a great thing because I don't know if we'll see Silvio or Paulie, but we're going to see the Sopranos timeline, the extended universe, apparently, because David Chase says he's going to do a prequel film. Now, John, they've been talking about doing a movie for the Sopranos. It's always been rumored for a long time. Mm-hmm. Obviously, with the late, great James Gandolfini passing away, and we don't even know the fate of what Tony Soprano really, what happened to him.
I just saw a black frame. Yeah.
Look, is the 60s... and doing Johnny Boy and Junior, is that the way to go if you're going to do a film or should you do a series?
No, I think this is an interesting decision by them because, once again, you're doing a prequel territory. It is kind of fraught with peril, this idea of doing prequels. Remember, Carlito's Way did a prequel with Carlito's Way Rise to Power,
right,
which wasn't that great. But David Chase coming into this, working on it for so long, we get a little background. Who else could do it but him? He knows these characters inside and out, knows how to give them life. You know, it's like Lucas doing his prequels. Once again, those are, you know, you can decide how you feel about that either way, but you want the person in charge of them to do the prequel because he understands what the life of these characters and how to connect it. It'll be interesting. But where he's setting it, I think, is really dangerous. Once again,
dangerous. Why dangerous?
Well, because this idea of racism, right? Here we go in the Newark race riots. What's going on here between the Italians and the African Americans in that community at that time? So there's going to be a lot of battles, and this is something that was really prevalent throughout the whole series as well. So it's an interesting time to set this prequel.
Sure, I understand what you're saying there, but I also think that David Chase handled it in The Sopranos. He's able to bring it in through. And I think they bring it in the 60s, and you have a creator like him who's excited about doing this. And revisiting this family again.
Yeah.
I think it makes sense. And I think that we will see Paulie Walnuts as a younger man. We'll see Sylvia. We'll see, you know, or maybe a lot younger. He's because he was a little older than Tony. We'll see Tony as a kid, I'm sure. And then be able to see what that family's all about. And then the good news as far as fans and as far as actors is they've revisited that time period inside the series a bunch of times too. So as actors to watch it again and learn a little bit more about it and really get it, because these aren't like brand new characters that have no history. There's developed stuff about what they have done and kind of where they were in their timeline. So I actually think this is a brilliant idea. I think it'll do really well. I think that you got to cast, obviously, like any other movie, you got to cast the right people. I think it's a juicy role for Johnny Boy. Could be a juicy role for Junior. I mean, how do you follow up?
Yeah, Dominic Cainese did such a great job with him. Yeah.
So, you know, I like that they're doing this, and I think that with obviously The Irishman coming out, we get a little bit. I'm always up for a good gangster movie. I agree with you with Carlito's Way that didn't work at all. But the difference was they didn't have as much juice to pull from.
Right, and they didn't have De Palma. Like you gotta have De Palma.
Yeah, and with Carlito though, Al Pacino really made Carlito.
Yeah, I hear what you're
saying. David Chase made the whole entire Sopranos universe, and you're not relying on having Tony here. You can make really good characters. I think it's a great idea, and I'm excited to see it.
Do you think we'll get, because there have been references to that past, like you said, in the series, do you think we'll get some of those stories or comments that have been alluded to throughout all those years of the series?
I hope so.
And get some background on those stories, maybe?
Well, because they were really prevalent things that happened in Johnny Boy's life, and then we know what kind of person, Livia Soprano was.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Like I said, juicy, juicy roles.
Yeah.
What do you guys think? Is this going to the barrel way too late? Do you think that they can make this work? Can they pull it off? Have a conversation in the comments below. And if it's your first time to Collider, welcome. Make sure that you comment and you subscribe and you share and you like and you do all that stuff. And then make fun of him on Twitter.
Please
kidding. Don't do that.